In this first tutorial video, we explore a bit about what we are learning, as well as a bit of history. We'll cover the operating systems and where Microsoft's DOS fits in the history of computing. Let's begin by defining what an operating system is. An operating system is the most important software that runs on a computer. It manages the computer's memory and processes, as well as all of its software and hardware. It allows us to communicate with the computer without knowing how to speak the computer's language. Without some sort of operating system, a computer is useless. Modern operating systems like Windows and Mac OS use a graphical user interface that lets us use a mouse to click on things like icons, buttons, and menus. In modern operating systems, everything is clearly shown on the computer screen graphically. However, MS-DOS is not a modern operating system. And unlike Windows, MS-DOS offers only a command line and is navigated by using MS-DOS commands. For example, in Windows, we would double-click a folder to see its contents. In MS-DOS, we use the CD, change directory, and DIR, directory of files, commands. Let's take a quick look at the history of operating systems. Back in the early days of the first computers in the late 1940s, there were no operating systems. Computers like the ENIAC were given the program to be run as well as the data at the same time, usually via punched paper cards. The first operating system was created in 1956 by General Motors Research Division for their IBM Model 704 mainframe computer. Although its major function was allowing batch processing of programs to be run on the computer, basically executing a new program after the previous one finished. In 1964, IBM released OS 360 for their System 360 mainframe computer and was the first operating system to allow for direct access storage devices like disk drives. At the dawn of the home computer age, the late 70s and early 80s, most microcomputers did not ship with a full-blown operating system. Instead, they had a built-in basic interpreter that was usually burned to a ROM that allowed some operating system functions to be run from BASIC. One of the first of these was the Altair 8800, launched in 1975. Its basic interpreter was written by two Harvard students, Bill Gates and Paul Allen, who would go on to form Microsoft. Gates and Allen ported their BASIC to other systems in development from Texas Instruments, Tandy, Apple, and Commodore, among others. Here's an example of a Commodore 64 getting a list of files from a floppy disk drive via BASIC. Also, at about this time, Gary Kidal of Digital Research developed the CPM operating system, which was ported, usually as an optional purchase, to many of the microcomputers of the late 70s. It was a true command line operating system for early microcomputers. In 1980, Tim Patterson of Seattle Computer Products essentially reverse-engineered Digital Research's CPM operating system and created 86DOS. The reason for this was Digital Research had not yet ported CPM to the Intel 8086 processor. In 1981, Microsoft ended up purchasing 86DOS from SCP for $75,000, and after some changes and enhancements, developed it as MS-DOS 1.0. Microsoft then licensed this operating system to IBM for their new IBM personal computer as PC-DOS 1.0. Due to the popularity of the IBM PC, Microsoft was able to further license MS-DOS to over 70 other companies in the first year alone. The rise of IBM-compatible computers increased demand for MS-DOS, and the final version before the introduction of Windows 95 was MS-DOS 6.22. This last version of MS-DOS is the one we're going to be going over in this series of tutorial videos. In the next video, I'll explain the MS-DOS file system, as well as go over the first few essential DOS commands. At any rate, that's all I have for this week. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.